Now we will see entropy of universe. Entropy of universe. Till now we have proved the entropy change for any process will be equal to del Q by T for the reversible process and greater than del Q by T for the irreversible process. Or for overall condition, we will see entropy change will follow this relation. Question 1. And we know that universe is an isolated system. And for the isolated system, no heat transfer from the system to boundary. It means del Q is equal to zero. It means entropy change for the universe or an isolated system, either it may be equal to zero or it may be greater than zero. It is the most important equation for any process that occur in the universe. I'll just highlight these process. The entropy change for the universe, either it may be equal to zero or it may be greater than zero for any process. This one. So if the first condition I'll write, the entropy change of the universe, entropy change of universe is equal to zero, it means the process is reversible process. The process is reversible process. In the second condition, if you will see the most important condition, if the entropy change of the universe is greater than zero, it means it represents irreversible process. But if in any condition the entropy change of universe, that is the entropy change of the system and surrounding, is less than zero, the process is completely impossible. It is not a possible process. Now we will see the TS diagram, because right now we have studied temperature as well as entropy. So we will study a TS diagram. If we will see the change of entropy, dS will be equal to del Q by T for a reversible process. If we will convert in the term of heat transfer, that will be equal to temperature multiplied with the entropy change. If we will see the same process on TS diagram, then we will see For a small change of entropy, that is your dS. This one is your dS and this is a temperature. Then this will be the area of the TS diagram about entropy axis. It means the heat transfer will be equal to the area, will be equal to area of TS diagram about entropy axis. This is most important point, so I'll highlight this point. The heat transfer for any reversible process, this will be equal to the area under TS diagram about entropy axis. Then the next topic of this one is combine first and second law of thermodynamic, of thermodynamic. If we will see the first law of thermodynamic for a reversible process, del Q will be equal to du plus PdV. This is valid. The first law of thermodynamic for the reversible process. And again, if we will see the second law of thermodynamic, that will be equal to T into dS. This one will be the second law of thermodynamic. Second law of thermodynamic. These both the law are valid. These both the law are valid for reversible process only. Reversible process. But if we will combine the first law and second law of thermodynamics, then we will see by the comparing of equation 1 and equation 2, this will be equal to TdS is equal to du plus PdV. This will be the combined first law and second law. Combine first law and second law of thermodynamic. Thermodynamic. But these are the combination of the properties. So properties are always point function. It means it can be valid for all the process or all the path. It means equation third. This equation third or combined first law and second law is valid. Equation third is valid for the reversible and irreversible process. For the reversible and irreversible process. Reversible and irreversible process. I'll just highlight the this is valid for the reversible and irreversible process. You know the first law and second law or equation 1 and 2. You know this is valid only for the reversible. But equation 3, that is the combination of both. It is valid for both the process, that is reversible as well as irreversible process. If we convert the equation 3 in the term of enthalpy, then we know that dH is equal to du plus PdV plus V into dP. If we will compare the equation 3 and this equation, we will see the TdS is equal to dH minus VdP. This is again the modification of equation 3, that is equation 4. This is also valid for reversible as well as irreversible process. That is again a star point. And now we will see how we'll represent our isobaric and isochoric process on TS diagram. Representation of constant pressure and constant volume process on TS diagram. TS diagram. For example, if I'll plot two process, that is the zero point and from zero point, sorry, this is a TS diagram. And from the zero point, I'll plot two process, a process 0 to 1 and this process 0 to 2. It is right now, it is very difficult to recognize what process is isobaric and what process is isochoric. But after completion this topic, we will completely recognize the which process is isobaric and which is isochoric process on TS diagram. Let's consider the first process, constant volume process. Volume process. And from the equation 3, we have seen the TdS is equal to du plus PDB. And for the isochoric process, dV is equal to 0. So TdS will be equal to dU. TdS will be equal to dU. Or you can say the TdS will be equal to CV to dt. Or the slope of isochoric curve, that is ds upon dt, the slope of isochoric curve, that is dt upon ds, will be equal to temperature upon CV. That is the slope of isochoric curve. And again we will see the second process, that is your constant pressure process. And in this process we will see the TdS is equal to dH minus BdP. But for the isobaric process, we know this term will be equal to 0. So TdS will be equal to dH, and we know that dH will be equal to Cp into dT, or dT upon dS for the isobaric process will be equal to temperature upon Cp. That is the slope of isobaric process. And if we will compare the slope of isobaric and isochoric process, then we will see the slope of isobaric process will be higher than the slope of isochoric process will be higher than the slope of isobaric process. So from the figure this one, we will see the process 0 to 1 is isochoric process and 0 to 2 is isobaric process. It means on the TdS equation, we can simply say process 0 to 1 is a isochoric process, and process 0 to 2 is a isobaric process. These two important points that will depend upon the slope. Now we will see the entropy change. Entropy change for an ideal gas. We know that TdS equation will be equal to dU plus PdV from the combined first law and second law of thermodynamics. Or dS, change of the entropy, will be equal to dU upon T plus PdV upon T. And for an ideal gas, PV is equal to mRT and dU is equal to mCpCvdT. Substitute the value in the equation, we will find dS will be equal to mCvdT upon T plus mRdV upon V. Now just to find the value of the entropy change from 1 to 2 state, we will integrate the equation. So we will see the entropy change for 2 state will be equal to mCv ln T2 upon T1 plus mR ln V2 upon V1. This is the entropy change for an ideal gas. I'll write this one as a equation 1 for the entropy change for an ideal gas. Again we will see the combined first law and second law of thermodynamics in the term of entropy, then we will see this term will be dH minus BdP. But for an ideal gas, For an ideal gas, we will see PV is equal to MRT and dH is equal to MCP dT. Substituting the value, we will see dS will be equal to MCP dT upon T minus MR dP upon P. Now, just changing or finding the value of the entropy change from 1 point to 2 point, we will integrate the equation. And then we will see the change of the entropy between 2 point will be equal to MCP ln T2 upon T1 minus MR ln P2 upon P1. This will be again the equation of the entropy change in the term of temperature and pressure. If we will compare the equation 1 and equation 2, comparing the equation 1 and equation 2, we will see entropy change in the term of pressure and volume will be equal to MCP ln V2 upon V1 plus MCV ln P2 upon P1. So, equation 1, 2 and 3 will be the equation of entropy change in the term of temperature, pressure and volume. Then the entropy change for a finite body. Let's consider a finite body from which the heat is rejected and the initial temperature of the body is Ti, and after the rejecting the heat, the temperature of the finite body is T final. Let's consider the change of entropy for the finite body will be equal to del Q upon T, and the change of entropy from the initial condition to the final condition, that will be equal to the integration of the heat divided by temperature. That value will be equal to the MC dT upon T, or the entropy change for a finite body will be equal to MC ln T final upon T initial. This is the entropy change equation for a finite body. This one will be the equation 4 for the entropy change. Next, the entropy change for a reservoir. Entropy change for a reservoir. Let's consider, first of all, we will consider a source whose temperature is T1 and heat is rejected from the reservoir, that is the source. So we will just check the entropy change for the reservoir, that will be equal to the Q1 upon T1, because temperature is constant and heat is rejected from the system. So I'll just indicate this one with the sign negative. Again, if we will consider it is a sink, temperature is T2 and heat is supplied to the sink Q2, then the entropy change of the sink, that will be equal to plus Q2 upon T2. This will be the equation for the sink, and this one will be the equation for the source. Now we will understand this entropy topic with a simple problem. First of all, we will start with a problem: an insulated closed vessel is divided into two parts with a partition. In part 1, mass specific heat and temperature is MC and T1. In part 2, mass, specific heat and temperature is MC and T2 respectively. Find the entropy change. Entropy change of the system. We will start this problem with a simple diagram. This is a closed insulated system or closed vessel. There are two partitions of this vessel. For first partition, mass is M, specific heat C and temperature at T1, and for the second partition, M, C and temperature at T2, suddenly partition is removed. So let consider first T1 is greater than T2, or you can consider T2 is greater than T1. So the heat loss by the first part will be equal to the heat gain by the second part, and the final temperature of both the body is somewhere T3. So heat loss by the first part will be equal to MC T1 minus T3, and heat gain by the second part will be equal to MC T2 T3 minus T2. By solving the equation, we will find T3 will be equal to algebraic or average of T1 and T2. T1 plus T2 by 2. If you have to find the total entropy change of the system, this will be equal to entropy change of the one part plus entropy change of second part, and entropy change of first part will be equal to MC ln T final upon T initial plus MC ln T final upon T initial for part 2, and this value will be equal to MC ln T3 square upon T1 into T2, or this value will be equal to T3 MC ln T3 upon under root T1 into T2 square, or just substituting the value of T3, then we will find the entropy change for the finite body or the system will be equal to T1 plus T2 by 2 upon under root T1 into T2. This will be the entropy change of this complete closed insulated vessel.